Mayong gabi sa ato ang tanan mga kaigsuunan. Welcome sa ato ang Daily Dose of the Word. Karong kagabi una, mag-uban na pod kita alang sa pagtuon sa pulong sa atong buhi na Dios. Agig pagsugod mga kaigsuunan, let's begin by way of singing. And ato ang yon, ang ato ang mga kaubanan to please come and sing for us.
Thy gun ko ang maluluwas kaya kong gilukar gihinlo ang ibalaan aron nga magamit niya kinabuhi
Salamat sa maong pag-awit. So, by this time, akong gihangyo ang tanan to please open your Bibles with me in the book of Hosea. Hosea, mga kaugsunan, Hosea, chapter 14. Okay, the last chapter, the book of Hosea, mga kaugsunan. And atong basahon ang chapter 14, the whole chapter, there are only 9 verses, mga kaugsunan. So, please, follow me with your eyes. The Bible says, O Israel, return unto the Lord thy God, for thou hast fallen by thine iniquity. Take with you words, and turn to the Lord. Say unto him, Take away all iniquity, and receive us graciously, so will we render the calves of our lips. Ashur shall not save us, we will not ride upon horses, neither will we say any more to the work of our hands, Ye are our gods, for in thee the fatherless findeth mercy. I will heal their backsliding. I will love them freely. For mine anger is turned away from him. I will be as the dew unto Israel. He shall grow as the lily, and cast forth his roots as Lebanon. His branches shall spread, and his beauty shall be as the olive tree, and his smell as Lebanon. They that dwell under his shadow shall return. They shall revive as the corn and grow as the vine. The scent thereof shall be as the wine of Lebanon. Ephraim shall say, What have I to do any more with idols? I have heard him and observed him. I am like a green fir tree. From me is thy fruit found. Who is wise? And he shall understand these things. Prudent, and he shall know them. For the ways of the Lord are right, and the just shall walk in them, but the transgressors shall fall therein. Let's pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we need your blessings again tonight. Alang sa imong ubos nga alagad, na mahimong masaysay imong pulong in a very special way that your people could understand. Ug alang pod Ginoo sa mga kaigsuunan nga anda maminaw ug magtuon sa imong pulong sa matagabii Ginoo. Ikaw pod magalig-on ug maghatag kanila sa mga pagtulunan. Nagkikinahanglan namo Lord alang sa amo ang kaayuhan ug alang sa pagligon sa mga pagtuo. Amahan, pasaylo ay intawon kami sa mga kasaypanan sa buhat sa pulong sa hunahuna. Ug itugot Ginoo nga mahimo kaming experiential Christians, not just people who are convinced with logic and philosophy of Christianity, but people who really experience Jesus, who really experience you, O Lord. Because if we're just convinced with the philosophy of Christianity, way pulos ang amo ang pagkakristuhanon Ginoo, we are just Christians in words and not in deeds. I am praying, Lord, nga ikaw maghatag ka na mo amahan og dakong kahigayunan, that we will also experience what we have, what we believe, and we will apply it sa mga kinabuhi, and we could have a true relationship with you, O God. Salamat sa imong kaayog, sa imong gugma lang ka na mo. Sa ngalan ni Jesus, gipangayo na mo ang tanan. Amen. And amen.
Amen.
Again, maayong gabi sa atong tanan, mga kaigsunan. Ang uluhan sa ato ang pagatunan karon is God's restoring ways. God's restoring ways. So, mga kaigsuunan, atong nailhan kung kinsa ni si Hosea. And if you are not familiar with the Old Testament, maybe dili pa kay ka nakailan ay kang Hosea, mga kaigsuunan, one of the prophets of the Northern Kingdom, mga kaigsuunan, dito sa Israel kaniadto. And si Hosea ang usa sa pinakaulahing propeta sa Northern Kingdom before ang captivity sa Assyria, because Northern Kingdom became captives of the Assyrian Empire while the Southern Kingdom became the captives of the Babylonian Empire. Pero ato makitaan, si Hosea is one of the last appeal sa Ginoo sa Northern Kingdom na magbag-o sila. Now, atong mailhan si Hosea, mga kaigsuunan, tungod sa grabe ka bugat nga sugo sa Ginoo sa iyaha, that he must take a wife from harlotry. Now, kaning maong si Gomer ang iyang asawa from harlotry. Now, I believe, mga kaigsuunan, nga ang first nga pag-ila-ila ni Hosea o ni Gomer, at first, Gomer was a pure woman, just like Israel, di ba? Israel, when Israel go out from Egypt, it is a pure maiden, woman, nga pictured as a woman, mga kaigsuunan, because Gomer represents Israel. And katong giingon sa Bible nga get a wife from harlotry, it is some futuristic nga kuan nga panghitabo nga mura ginaingnan ni sa Ginoo si Hosea, that your wife will become a prostitute one day. Just like sa Israel, Israel was taken by God as a pure nation, but afterwards, when they were in the promised land, they began to be unfaithful sa Ginoo, and they began to worship other gods. Na hulog sila sa idolatry, mga kaigsuunan. So, mabod na yung nahitabo kang Hosea. Si Hosea, nagkuha siya sa ka-asawa, a very, very pure and beautiful woman named Gomer. But in the process of time, si Gomer, mga kaigsunan, she became unfaithful. Nahimo siyang unfaithful, and Gomer live with other men. And iyang gi-BIBI si Hosea, mga kaigsunan, og nakigpuyo siya sa ubang mga kalalakinan nga sibisag kinsa na lang, mga kaigsunan. And ang sugo sa Ginoo kang Hosea, even if your wife will be like that, you need to court her again, imo siyang balikan, imo siyang dawaton pag-usab og higugmaon pag-usab nga murag way nahitabo. Grabe kalisod nga sugo ngadto kang Hosea, mga kaigsuunan. But their life is a picture or a metaphor to the relationship of God to His people. Kay when the Lord took Israel to be a nation in which ngayahang i-bless, and murabitog, nahimo niyang wife ang nation ni Israel, mga kaigsunan, ato makitaan Israel was pure, Israel was something cherished pag-ayo sa Ginoo. But when Israel came to the promised land, Israel go to the other gods of the land and worship other gods. And there was idolatry, and that is spiritual adultery, mga kaigsunan, when you worship other gods. Now, ang nahitabo karon sa Israel, they were punished by God, na capture sila, grabe ang ilang mga paglisod. But afterwards, gibalikan sila sa Ginoo, girenew sila sa Ginoo, girestore sa Ginoo ang tanang nangawala sa ilaha, and God blessed them again nga murag walay nahitabo. So inana ang nahitabo, inana ang gugma o kaluoy sa Ginoo sa iyang mga katawhan, mga kaigsunan, to which the life of Hosea must picture it out. You see? So sa diha nga nagwali si Hosea, mga kaigsunan, kung unsa ang gustong isultis Ginoo sa Israel, nabati pud niya kung unsa ang gibati sa Ginoo. Si Hosea can understand God by experience because of what had happened sa iyang kinabuhi. You know, the best advice you can get is from people who truly suffered sa ilang kinabuhi. Itong mga tao nga naglisod, itong mga tao nga nakaagig mga pag-antos, kasakit silang kinabuhi, often you can get good advices from them because they have been there and suffered firsthand ang mga kasakit sa ilang kinabuhi, and they had found God. And through the comfort that they have found of God, through the comfort that they have get from God, the same comfort they will be using to comfort others who are going through the same circumstances. You see, so muna nahitabok ang Hosea, mga kaigsunan. In a nutshell, ang tibuok Hebrew book of Hosea, mga kaigsunan. Now, sa chapter 14, murag nakitaan, ato makitaan ang appeal sa Ginoo. Kabalo ka, once we were talking with my wife, and naman may quiz diri sa among simbahan, and we are reading through the minor prophets, and ang every first week of the month nami Bible quiz gikan sa Old Testament kaning mga minor prophets. And niana kong wife nga grabe ang Ginoo dino, kay every minor prophets nga iyang mabasahan, grabe kayo ang kainit sa kasuko sa Ginoo from chapter 1 hangtod sa last chapter. Pero ayha mahuman ang writing sa minor prophet, there is always an appeal from God nga gihigugma sila sa Ginoo, pabalikon sila sa Ginoo, kay i-bless sila pag-usab sa Ginoo, kay ang Ginoo naghulat lang sa ilaha. After the great heat of God's wrath within the book, at the last part of it, there is always a shower of love, grace, mercy offered to them. Inana kamayo ang Ginoo, mga kaigsunan. In the midst of His anger, He always remembers mercy. You see? You read it for yourself. Basahan ninyo ang mga minor prophets and you will discover nga inana ka, grabe ang gugmas Ginoo. Suko na kayo ang Ginoo, naglagot na kayo ang Ginoo sa ilaha, mga kaigsuonan, tungod sa ilang mga gibuhat because of their idolatry. They have left God. Ilang gibiyaan ang Ginoo, gibibiyay nila ang ilang pagtuo, ilang gibaliwala, gitrample underfoot ang pulong sa Ginoo. But afterwards, God always offer them mercy, love, grace, and restoration. So inana pud ang ginabuhat sa Ginoo sa imo, mga kaigsunan. Maybe nalayo kas Ginoo karon, but He is always calling for you, waiting for you with both hands open na mobalik sa iya, because He is offering you love, mercy, grace, restoration sa imong kinabuhi. Now let's go to our text, mga kaigsunan. So much for the background. I hope na in a nutshell nakit-an ninyo kung unsa day ning book of Hosea. Now, this is sa chapter 14 sa tuang text, mga kaigsunan. Atong tanawon ang verse 1. It is actually a prayer, okay? And an appeal to Israel, and it must be their prayer to God. Ingon pa ni Hosea, O Israel, return unto the Lord thy God, for thou hast fallen by thine iniquity. So, the prophet is appealing to Israel, balik na mo sa Ginoo, nahulog mo tungod sa inyong pagpakasala, balik na mo sa iya, go back to God. So, ato makita nga, just like Gomer, si Gomer nangabit, nangitag laing laki, nya nakig-ipon sa laing laki, and ato makit-an mga kaigsuonan nga at least one of the three children nila ni Hosea o ni Gomer, at least one of the of them is not Hosea's child. You see, it was a child of harlot tree tungod sa iyang pagpangabit. Na ato makit-an mga kaigsuonan, that's why the name means not my people. I think that was Lorohama, not my people. You see, so ato makit-an mga kaigsuonan nga inana ka grabe ang ilang pagpakasala, just like Israel. Israel made alliance with other gods, worship idols, serve idols, but God is saying return, balik. Murag bana nga naghangyo sa iyang asawa, balik na kay ay gawala ka higugmaon tara gihapon ka bisan pag mauna ang imong gibuhat sa imong kinabuhi. So ato makit-an mga kaigsuonan that it is an appeal from God through the prophet, mabalik na ang kaning mga tawhana, ang mga God's people sa tilan sa Ginoo, because He will always receive them. Now, let us try to look at other part of the scripture to shed more light sa gipasabot sa atuang teksto mga kaigsuonan. Tanawa gani. In Isaiah chapter 55, please open your Bibles there in verse 6 to 7. Isaiah 55 verse 6 to 7. Look at this. Seek ye the Lord while He may be found. Call ye upon Him while He is near. Look at this. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, and He will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for He will abundantly pardon. So ato makit-an mga kaigsuonan that God is appealing that we must forsake our old ways. Biyain na ang imong mga daotang binuhatan. Go back to God because He will abundantly pardon. Ang iyang pardon, absolute, kalimtan niya. As if you will become a new man. That's why we call it born again. Maanak kapag usab. God will not just give you another chance, but He will give you new life. New life to begin with, mga kaigsuonan. You see, God will not say that you renovate your life. No, He will give you a new life to begin with, mga kaigsuonan. He will give you a fresh beginning. That's why He wanted you to be born again in the family of God. You see? Now, kung tanawin mo ang Jeremiah chapter 3 verse 12 to 14, mga kaigsuonan. Jeremiah, open your Bibles there please. Chapter 3 verse 12 to 14. Unsa man ang giingon sa pulong sa atong Ginoo? The Bible says, go and proclaim these words toward the north, and say, return thou backsliding Israel, saith the Lord, and I will not cause mine anger to fall upon you, for I am merciful, and the Lord, and I will not keep anger forever. You see that? Only acknowledge the iniquity, angko na lang nga nakasala mo, that thou hast transgressed against the Lord thy God, and hast scattered thy ways to the strangers under every green tree, and ye have not obeyed my voice, saith the Lord. Turn, O backsliding children, saith the Lord, for I am married unto you. Look at that. God is married unto Israel, unto you, and I will take you one of a city and two of a family, and I will bring you to Zion. Look at that, mga kaigsuonan. You see? So ato makit anong God is calling them. And praise God, even pa sa verse 15, and I will give you pastors according to mine heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. So ato makit-an mga kaigsuonan, God is appealing to Israel. Go back, balik na. Okay, the relationship will be restored. Nga murag bag-o, nga murag wala gyud samad. You see? So, higala, maybe I am talking to somebody tonight. Maybe you have been very, very far from God. Nalahiyo ka na sa Ginoo. To those people who will be watching afterwards sa YouTube, maybe I am talking to you tonight. Go back to God and He will always receive you again. Dawaton kaniya pag-usab. Now, ang tambag ni Hosea sa Israel in verse 2, look at this. Paniya, take with you words and turn to the Lord. Say unto Him, take away all iniquity and receive us graciously, so will we render the calves of our lips. So bring praises again to the Lord, kaning calves of our lips, meaning praises mga kaigsuonan. Mga pagdayig, pag-usab, nga pagdayig nga na action. You see, ang Ginoo mga kaigsuonan, He wanted action. dili niya gusto ng kanabi taong empty words nga saad nga saad gas Ginoo, di ba? Sayon ra kay mo ampo nga Ginoo, tagaay kog kuso Ginoo nga ako mapasan akong cross para makasunod ko nimo. It's very very easy to pray that, but it is another thing to really pick up your cross, carry it and follow Jesus. Do not just pray nga tagaay kog kuso Ginoo nga mapasan ako kong cross. No, do not just pray that, you must pick up your cross actually and then start following Christ. Di ba? Nga na ka, Lord, tagaay kong kusog, nga matagbo na ako ni akong mga pagsulay, tagaay kong kusog, nga pasan ako ni akong mga kasakit, masulbad akong problema, and do not just stay there and lay down waiting sa panalangin nga mabot, but you must stand up and face the problem, face the trial, face the trouble, believing that God will answer your prayer, that He will give you strength and the solution for it. You see? So, muna yung problema sa Christianity karon. Ang Christianity karon mga kaigsuunan, is puro na lang dada, puro na lang salita. Wala na'y buhat, mga kaigsuunan. So, ato makitaan that faith is not just that is the ending of the journey. Sa diha nga nagtuo na ka, nagdawat na ka kang Jesus Christ, it doesn't mean that you will lay down and wait for His coming. No, it means the beginning of a journey. You see? Unsa man ang gibuhat sa tanawagan ng books, Acts chapter 2, mga kaigsuunan. Look at this. Muni ang tinuod nga Christianity nga gitudlo sa pulong sa Ginoo, di ba? In verse 38, then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized every one of you in the name of Jesus. So ato makitaan, that was the preaching of Peter. Now, what happened to them mga kaigsuunan? Ato makitaan in verse 42, the Bible says verse 41, then they that gladly receive his word were baptized unto the same day, and were added unto them about 3,000 souls. So they believe. They received this word. What happened after the belief? What happened after the faith? Verse 42. And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine. They continued steadfastly. So mga kaigsuunan, I am sick of counting reports. I am sick of counting na ay napulo kabuk na save, na ay 20 kabuk na save. I am sick of that. Pait pamalandungon mga kaigsunan, they are truly saved if they steadfastly follow the Lord afterwards. You see? Maybe they were just changed, or they were just morabitog, tandog lang sa emotional appeal sa preacher, ni forward, ni dawat, kunuhay kang Jesus Christ. But if they will not continue steadfastly, I question the integrity of their salvation. I am not God. Dili ko Dios mga kaigsunan. Pero every time I find the Bible nga naay mga luwas, pagkahuman na maluwas, ma-follow sila kang Jesus, and they will live their life for Jesus. And in the New Testament, mga kaigsuunan, the book of Acts, to be a Christian is a very, very unpopular thing to do. Nga naman, tanawin mo afterwards, kaning 3,000 nga mga nagtuo kang Jesus Christ, nga nabautismuhan, o niya nag-follow kang Jesus Christ, o siya nahitabo. Some of them were killed. Some of them cost all their wealth because of their faith, newfound faith. Some of them were persecuted, and most of them were scattered abroad afterwards, if you read the book of Acts. But they did not go back to their old world. They did not go back to their old religion. They stayed because they know the true Jesus. They know the true Jesus. So I hope that Christianity today will be sick of hearing reports, hundreds, thousands, how many people received the Lord Jesus Christ. That's rubbish if they will not follow Jesus afterwards. You see? So mga kaigsuunan, I hope by the grace of God, we will see true conversion sa itong panahon karon. Because gamay na lang kayo ang true conversion sa itong panahon karon mga kaigsuunan. That's why the Bible says, that the Bible appeal, that we must turn to the Lord and take away all our iniquity. The Bible says, di ba? Receive graciously, so we'll render the cobs of our lips. Praises to God. We continue. Not just lip service. Nay kapadayunan. And sa verse 3, ato makitaan sa itong text going back. Assur shall not save us. Will not ride upon horses, neither will we say any more to the work of our hands, you are our gods, for in thee the fatherless findeth mercy. Meaning in verse 3, magsaad na sila, nga Ginoo, di nami musalig sa tao, Ginoo, di nami magsalig sa mga Dios, kay ikaw mo itinuod nga nakatabang ka na mo. So atong makitaan mga kaigsuunan, that they will, because ani mangong panahon ni Hosea,
Northern Kingdom is always trusting to the might of other countries. Pagirahon sila, magpakitabang sila sa Egypt. Pagirahon sila, makitabang sila sa lahing nasud. And they forgot God. Nakalimot sila sa Ginoo. They are asking the help of idols. They are asking the help of other nations instead of asking God. Diba? In Isaiah chapter 31 verse 3, sila nga gipangayo ag tabang ug ang gitabangan, both of them will fall, the Bible says. Kay God is a jealous God. He wanted His people to come to Him if they're in trouble. So ato makitaan mga kaigsuunan, saad ng Israel na Ginoo, we will come to you. We will forsake the horses of other nation. We will forsake the idols. You are the one who help us. Now, kung kaning verse 1 to verse 3, if Israel will pray this prayer with their heart, you see, remember this, ang imo mang motivation behind sa imong action ang gitan-aw sa Ginoo. Di ba? Naay mga katawhan ingon nga, ay, kung gusto kag favor sa Ginoo, pag-fasting ayo pagkaon. Kung gusto kag favor sa Ginoo, pag-ampo hangtod alas 12 gabi. That's good. If done because of what is truly happening inside. Fasting, prayer is useless mga kaigsuunan if you are doing it for the mere action. You see, for the mere action of fasting, for the mere action of praying, if you are doing it for that action alone, for the sake of the action alone, that's useless. Ngano man, the real blessing or the real source that you will receive favor from God, if you truly mean it from inside. You see, alas 12 na kanatulog sa gabi, tungod sa imong pag-ampo, pero imo lang itong gibuhat kay imong hunahuna, gusto kag favor sa Ginoo, imo to, kay imong i-please sa Ginoo, ang Ginoo sa imong action, that's useless, that's rubbish. It must be something nga you mean business with God. You are sincere, mo nang abdan ka gabi, nga naman, sincere kay ka, naghulat kay kas Ginoo. And that's the time that God will bless. Nga naman, nakit ani imong kasing-kasing. You see? So, kung imo nang buhaton, imong pa ang Ginoo, verse 1, verse 4, look at this. I will heal their backsliding. I will love them freely. For mine anger is turned away from him. And we praise and thank the Lord for that. In Jeremiah chapter 3 verse 22, ang giingon sa pulong sa Ginoo mga kaigsuunan, look at this. The Bible says, return ye backsliding children, and I will heal your backslidings. Behold, we come unto thee, for thou art the Lord our God. So God will heal. God will heal our backsliding. If we will just come back to Him sincerely. You see? Basin siguro nag-backslide ka karun, igsoon. Sa itong panahon karun, the problem is not idolatry anymore, nga ka ng mga Diyos-Diyos. The problem, mga kaigsoonan, is our priorities sa itong mga kinabuhi. We prioritize other things more than the reading of scriptures, more than prayer, more than church, more than attendance sa church. Higala, the world today needs to go back to God. You see, preachers needs to go back to the Bible preaching. Dili na ng mga magic sa unsa ba ng mga murag mga life coach ng mga pastor karon. Mangita na og mga quotation nga mga nindot kaayo kay mo na iwali dili na ang pulong sa Ginoo pagkawa og pulos. So atong makit-an mga kaigsuonan, we must go back to God. Go back to God and receive kung unsa mga kaigsuonan ang gitawag nga angay gyud natong buhaton alang sa tong Ginoo gidiman sa Ginoo. Now if we will do it, tanaw ang gingon sa verse 5 to verse 7, look at this, kung basahon pag-usab, I will be as the dew unto Israel. Wow. He shall grow as a lily and cast forth his roots as Lebanon. Diba sa oriental kaniadto, diba kay usually pagting init dito sa ilaha, ang ilang ginasaligan nga source of water nga mabugnawan ang mga tanom is ang dew or ang hamog. Pagbuntag sa iyo, daghan ng hamog, mga kaigsuunan. You see? And diya, ang source of water sa mga kasagraan, sa mga tanom, mga kaigsuunan. And ato, and God says, I will be like a dew sa inyo, ha? So I will refresh you again. You see? And cast forth his roots as Lebanon. His branches shall spread and his beauty shall be as the olive tree and his smell as Lebanon. They that dwell under his shadow shall return. They shall revive as the corn and grow as the vine and scent thereof shall be as the wine of Lebanon. What does it mean? Meaning God will restore everything that is lost. tanan nimong nawala tingod sa imong pag-backslide, tanang nangawala mga kaigsuonan, tanang mga nangahanaw, nangaguba sa imong kinabuhi, i-restore sa Ginoo. God will restore a broken family. God will restore a broken business. God will restore a broken health. God will restore unsay pwede pa niya i-restore mga kaigsuonan. Just go back to Him. O ang pinakanindot na i-restore sa Ginoo, God will restore a broken heart. And there will be again joy. Higala, unsaon man nimo kung nabalik ang imong pamilya, unsaon man nimo kung namaayo imong panglawas, unsaon man nimo kung gitawag nga daghang ka nagkwarta, kung wag yapong kay kalipay. Pinaka-importante, satisfaction in God, ibalik sa Ginoo. Joel chapter 2, open your Bibles there please, mga kaigsunan. Human lang aning Hosea, after Hosea, the book of Joel, chapter 2, verse 25 to 27. Kung sa man ang giingon sa pulong sa Ginoo, mga kaigsunan, the Bible says, and I will restore to you the years that the locust have eaten, the canker worm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you, and ye shall eat in plenty and be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord your God that hath dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never be ashamed, and ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I am the Lord your God and none else, and my people shall never be ashamed. Sigala, He will restore. Padaghanon pa niya. And that's the God that we are serving. We say amen to that. You see? Now, because of it, if the restoration will happen after that you come back to God, tanawa ang dapat iingon sa Ephraim. And it pictures us on sa tong angay iingon. Ephraim shall say, after it, what have I to do anymore with idols? Sa man ako ang buhaton sa mga idols? Sa man ang pulos sa mga Diyos-Diyos? Di na ko alam mga Diyos-Diyos, walay pulos. So, igala, Ikson, biyain ang mga Diyos-Diyos. Pasinapay Diyos-Diyos, imong kinabuhi karon. Ah, igala, ihatag na sa Ginoo. Surrender na sa Ginoo, ihatag si mong pastor. Ilabay na na mga kaigsuonan. Parawa na kaibalikan. So, ato makitaan nga, muna na ka, what's the use of idols? Diba? What have I to do with idols? I have heard him and observed him. I am like a green fir tree. From me is thy fruit found. If you wanted to be fruitful, come to God. Cast every idol. Diba muna yung giingon sa 1 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 9? That how ye turn from idols to serve the living God? So turn away from idols and serve the living God, mga kaigsunan. Now, verse 9. The last appeal. Ni Isaiah, ni Hosea, mga kaigsunan, who is wise? Kinsa may manggialamon? Kinsa may tinuod nga utukan? Kinsa may tinuod nga naay kasayuran, naay kaalam? And he shall understand these things, prudent, and he shall know them, for the ways of the Lord are right. So mga kaigsunan, if you are truly wise, kung manggialamon yung God, isunda ang Ginoo. Follow him, kaya ano man, he is right. So dili, sumala pa sa mga istorya karon nga ang babae daw palaging tama, pero ang tinuod, ang Diyos ang palaging tama, mga kaigsunan. God is always right. He is always right, mga kaigsunan. Now ato makitaan that nga the Lord, okay, for the ways of the Lord are right, and the just shall walk in them. If you are just, if you are righteous, you will walk in the ways of God. But the transgressors or the sinners shall fall therein. So mga kaigsuunan, I hope with the grace of God, this appeal ni Hosea sa mga children of Israel is also true to us. Because we often leave the worship of God and we forsake God, follow some entertainment, follow some useless things tong kinabuhi. But igsuon, go back to God. He's waiting for you. Basi nasa to akron daring, you wanted to go back to God, but you don't know where to begin. Begin by assuring your salvation. Namatay si Jesus Christ tungod sa imong mga sala. Gibayaran niya ang imong guilt. Gibayaran niya ang imuhang penalty. In the cross, He suffered there for you. He was buried. And praise God, gidaog niya ang kamatayon. Gipildi niya. Kay nabanhaw siya, mga kaigsunan, and because he is alive, kay buhi siya, he can save you now if you call upon him. Tawga siya, kay luwason kaniya. Repent, pag hinulsol na sa imong mga sala, ug tuuhi si Jesus Christ imong tibuok sing kasing, and He will save you tonight, my friend. One more song alang kanimo igsoon.
Laring kamot ko patungas, matagad daw paitas. Kanunay nang aliya ko, ningdapit ako dada. Dapit na may pagdaog, may atas pangadapit, dinodala ko dito. Maokiling tingo ako na akong dapit nga may pagdaog, may atas pangadapit, ginodada ko dito. Buot ko nga malantawan ang dalagsa sa himaya mo. Ginupatindog ako sa dapit nga may pagdaog, may atas pangadapit, ginodada
Thank you for that wonderful song. So, mga kaigsunan, let's close ato ang Bible study tonight by way of prayer. Let's pray. Glorious, loving Heavenly Father, mong pangalan, among gidayig, among gisimba, among gipasidang, pasidunggan, Ginoo, daligun ka sa walay katapusan. Kaya ang Diyos ang natag-iestanan, Diyos nga nahigugma ka na mo, Diyos nga anna mo pasaylo, Ginoo, sa mga kasaypanan. Ginoo, kami nagaduol karon, nagapangalyupo, nagpaubo sa mga kagalingon, nagapangayo sa imong kaluoy, Ginoong Diyos. Pasailua, intahon kami sa mga kalapasan, sa buhat, sa pulog, sa unahuna. Itugot, Ginoo, nga sa matagabi, nga among pagtunaan ni mong pulong, doon ay mga kalayo nga magdilaab sa mga kasing-kasing, na kanunay musanag sa mga kinabuhi, Ginoong Diyos, sa pag-iya ka na mo, sa pagsunod o pag tuman sa kabubuto ni Kristo Jesus sa among mga kinabuhi. Salamat, Ginoo, ng mga katauhan who are very, very faithful, following you every night, and listening sa imong pulong, Ginoo, loving you, Lord. Salamat, Ginoong Diyos, because we have this opportunity to praise Jesus and to love Jesus more than anything else. Ikaw magawan ka na mo, Amahan. Ikaw magabless ka na mo. And help us to spread the good news to more people para mas daghan pang mga lumas. In Jesus' precious name, gipangayo na mong tanan. Amen. And amen. Salamat.
Amen.
Og maayong gabi sa atong tanan.
Salamat po. Salamat po. Maayong gabi.